Welcome to the Ask Ultra Show, and I'm Malachi, and this is your weekly dose of kidpreneur magic. Now, before we get started, here is today's riddle. A pregnant lady named her children Dominic, Regis, Michael, Fawn, Sophie, and Lara. What will she name her next child? Jessica, Katie, Abby, or Tilly? Stay with me to the end of the show to get the answer. Now, if you've started a business or you're thinking of starting a business, marketing is definitely a topic you're going to need to be familiar with. Whether your business is based on a product or a service, it could be the best thing since sliced bread. You'll struggle to have a successful business if you can't let people know in a convincing way. Marketing is simply promoting and telling people about your product or service. The purpose of marketing is to get your business, product, or service seen and known by customers in the hope that they will buy it from. Can you think of some ways that you've seen people doing this? Here's some I think you can do. Yes, you. So there's social media, sending emails, WhatsApp, going to events, having a stall, advertising on websites or apps, giving out leaflets, and even just speaking to people, starting with friends and family. These different types of marketing are known as marketing channels. You can choose to only use one marketing channel or as many as you want. But what you should think about when choosing a marketing channel is whether the cost in money, time, or both is worth it. You'll want to keep an eye on what marketing channels works the best by tracking how your customers found out about your business when they buy from you. If you have a website, there are services like Google Analytics that can help you see where your customers come from, or you might simply ask where they found out about your business. Once you have this information, you can choose to invest more time, money, or both into marketing channels that work the best. By doing this, you should get more paying customers, which is what you want. This is known as return on investment, or ROI. Fortunately or unfortunate, depending on how you look at it, there is no secret sauce to marketing. What works well for one business may not necessarily work for another. As a young aspiring kidpreneur, it's important to understand who your target customer is and how you can best make your product or service attractive to them. Your target customer is the type of customer which best fits your business. For example, if you sell beauty products, then you should target someone who is interested in beauty. By doing this, you can try to get the best return on investment on your marketing activity. Once you understand your target customer, you can plan your marketing activities in order to reach them in the hope that they will buy from you and get a great return on investment. Happy day. Think about your customers' behaviors and characteristics so you can choose the most effective marketing channel. Think about stuff like what your target customer usually does. Do they watch TV, go on specific websites or social media, watch Netflix, go to restaurants or movies? Do they only spend money at certain times, or are they more likely to spend money at other times? What problems do they have? Do they like or shop from brands you know? And what celebrities or influencers do they look up to? Another clever way that some companies use to market their businesses are through partnerships or product placement. If you use social media, you'll have come across this marketing technique. Brands will give people who have big followings, like celebrities or who are Insta-famous, their products and might ask them to post a picture using the product on their social media. These people are often called influencers. Being an influencer may mean you know a lot about a topic or are good at something and people look up to you, or just that you're popular online. The brand may create a special discount code for the influencer that customers use to get money off any purchases they make. This can be an effective way to reach customers, as the person they've partnered with has a big reach and the brand will get exposure to a lot of people who are interested in their product. An example of this is a young fitness entrepreneur called Nathaniel Messiah. He started posting workout videos on YouTube and Instagram and grew a huge following. Based on this, he was able to get a partnership with a nutrition brand called MyProtein with a specific discount code which gives customers money off any orders they make. Today, there are loads of ways to market your business using the internet, and as young entrepreneurs, we are really fortunate. Although we spoke about return on investment earlier and thinking about how much you should spend, friend, it's also possible to start a business while marketing on the internet and social media for free. That's right, free. Social media is one of the most effective and popular marketing channels that you can use right now. All you need is a phone, Wi-Fi, and you can start promoting a product or service right now and make money. The great thing about social media is that it is really social. You think about the old days of my dad before the internet, I mean before that was Fortnite, word of mouth would have been an important way to get people to know about your business, and it could happen naturally. Once people had used a product or service they really liked, they would tell us. This would create word of mouth marketing. It's human nature that if a product or service works well, helps people, or is an improvement on something people already use, then people will share it with others. Back in the day, this would literally happen through conversation. That's why it's called word of mouth. But that's usually limited to one, people you knew, and two, people who live near you. Fast forward to today, because of the internet and social media, with a couple of clicks, information can be shared with millions of people instantly. You may have also heard of people going viral, but if you haven't, this means a piece of content has become incredibly popular in just a matter of hours or days by being shared by thousands, sometimes even millions of people on social media. In order for your product or service to go viral, you probably need to be creative and think outside of the box. Again, think of your customer. What kind of content would they like to see online? What would they share with their friends or find interesting? A great example of this is Blendtec's Will It Blend YouTube videos. I mean, there are probably thousands of different blenders, different brands and prices of blenders, and it would be considered a crowded market, meaning the business has lots of other companies to compete with. Because of this competition, Blendtec came up with a great way to make their brand stand out. To show how great their blenders were, they blended stuff you wouldn't expect a blender to be able to do. Some of the things they blended include iPhones, iPads, baseball, magnets, golf clubs, crowbars, toy cars, and lots more. Blendtec's videos went viral, racking up almost 300 million views on their YouTube channel. This helped to increase their sales 5 times over. Not bad, right? So to summarize, when marketing your business, first, think about who your customer is. Second, think about what marketing channels would work best. Third, track the results of your marketing efforts. Invest more time, money, or both into the channels that work well and less in those that aren't that effective. Fourth, do something creative and different that you can share online so that you can get in front of the right people. If you're familiar with fishing, it's a bit like that. Think of your marketing as bait, or maybe a better example, bees that are attracted to flowers for their color, scent, the type of flower it is. Your marketing activities are like flowers. With the right channels, your customers, like bees, and be attracted to your business like bees are to flowers, and hopefully they'll buy from you. And wouldn't that be great? Get it? Thank you for staying with me till the end of this video. And as promised, the answer to today's riddle, which was, a pregnant lady named her children Dominic, Regis, Michael, Fawn, Sophie, and Lara. What will she name her next child? Jessica, Katie, Abby, or Tilly? And the answer is Tilly. She seems to follow the scale. Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, and then T. Did you get it? Did you get it? Did you get it? If you did, give yourself a big pat on the back. If you didn't, better luck on the next video. And if you want to keep learning how to be a successful entrepreneur now or in the future, don't forget to click that big red subscribe button, like the video, or YouTube won't share this with anyone else. Click the bell icon and share this video with someone you love. See you next time. Ultra out.